Hi, welcome to CAT TB5 video tutorial. Now the F1 rear wing exercise in CAT TB5. Slightly different to the NX version, but you could do, of course, the NX version like the CAT TB version. So, let's have fun with CAT TB5. I've already prepared some geometric sets, one for my reference planes, one for the sketches, one for curves and one for surfaces. You could of course insert more geometric sets because it makes it much easier to model. So let's go for the reference planes. Let's start, where are my planes? Here they are. I want one parallel to this one, and the distance should be 660. Another one, let's make a double click, and this one should be 375. Another one with -375. Next one with 200. Usually you should make this locked. Okay, and then one with, let's say, 100. And one with, now I could, yeah, that's 235. Next one is 235 plus 135. Another one with plus 135. And I think I need a last one. Yeah. That would be 505 plus 135. And cancel this out. Okay. Now let's switch to the sketches geometric set. You could do it over here as well. And I want to do it with one sketch and use the output feature to put all the curves outside the sketch, or you could do it with one curve per sketch as well. So let's go for positioned one, looks good. Hide these yellow projected elements. And I want to have a rectangle first. I don't want to use those parallel constraints. And give it some dimensions. This might be 650. And that might be 650 as well. Now let's put this line onto that axis, coincident, and this one here. And you might notice with every exercise I do, this whole process improves because every time I do it in a different program, I got new ideas. So you could watch all, not only the one which you're really interested in, but you could watch all just to see the process of improvement. It's a sort of an evolution. Coincident, okay. Now let's add a spline. Okay. Could go like this. Okay, now let's activate the tangency the last point, this one, and then you could make this parallel to that one or perpendicular to that one. So let's do it with perpendicular. Okay, now I want to cut off a little bit over here, and I want to cut off with a line like that. This could go up to this one, but it need not go up there. Okay, let's trim. Double click. Okay, this should go away. That one, this one, this one, that one, this one, that one, this one, this, this, and that. It's not fully constrained, but that doesn't really matter right now. And I want to have a fillet. I would do that in the sketch. There you go. Make this, for example, 100, and make that distance 100, and okay, looks good. Now I want to add more sketches here, oh, not sketches but curves. I want to do it with one sketch, or no, I will do it in more sketches. So let's switch to the next sketch. Sorry, still was selected. Cut here acts like this. So another sketch on the same plane as before, on this one. Okay, hide those elements and the curve should be an arc, so go for a 3-point arc. Make it maybe like this. Okay, next sketch. Again on that plane, okay. Hide. But in this case, I will do all the sketches at first. So I need some arcs here. Where are my arcs? Here they go. One should be here. Maybe like this. And of course you could make this the distance, for example, so let's say 520, less, 515, maybe like this, and okay, and then another sketch. There are only two options. You could use output feature, or you could do it with different sketches, because in Criteria you're not able to select only one part of a sketch, as in NX. So another sketch, again on that plane. Hide those. And another arc, which would be maybe like this. Okay, could align those, go for construction line. And use a distance, maybe 5 and 08. Maybe 505, 505. Okay. Then I need another sketch. Okay. For those slots, I will use rectangles. So in this case, I have to delete all those parallel constraints because I don't need them. So select it all and deselect those coincidences because I want to use those. And I will put all those three rectangles in one sketch because it's possible, and I could, of course, put them in different sketches. So make this one maybe 10, this one 10, and that one 10, and those distances might be 15 and 15. Okay. Now I could move this up a little bit, maybe like this. And that's because I didn't constrain it in that direction. But therefore you could create something more with a slight angle if you want. Let's align this and that and make distance. Sorry, I wanted to have a distance. Come on. Maybe 20, that's okay. And one. ...90-degree angle. That's okay. I don't need those sketches to be easy constrained. So I think I've got all the sketches I need and I could move on. Seems I forgot to hide those elements here, so let's hide them. And I also forgot I need one more sketch. I could do it on that plane or on this plane. I will do it on that plane. So let's go for precision sketch. Sorry. Go for a position sketch on that plane, swap, hide those. It's just a line, which is of course coincident in that plane. And it should be long enough to cover all of this. That's okay. And now I've got all my sketches. No, I need one more maybe, but I will split, so I think I don't need. Oh yeah, of course. This should be maybe like this, it should cover. That position, that's okay. And of course another line in the same plane here. Confirm. So this one, I forgot. Ah, gee. Okay, I want a sketch. Position one right here. Swap. Okay. Hide those. And a line which goes maybe like this. And this one should be in that plane coincident. Okay, so let's take a look. Maybe this should go up a little bit. As well. So the arc was sketched too. So this needs a little bit of adjustment. Okay, now I can start to make surfaces. First, an extrude. With that line, should go in both directions, in this direction and in that direction. So could I go up to that plane, or I could go for more? Let's go for, let's say 700 or 750, and the other one, so hopefully really 750. That's sort of crazy. That's 750, and this might be 150 or even 200. That's okay. Next one was this one. Another extrude. Same dimensions, okay. Now let's trim this surface with that curve, or let's do an extrude. So go for an extrude. Because if you want to trim it with that curve, you have to project that curve onto that surface. So we'll go for extrude. This should be 0 on that 750 is okay. And I could use an offset plane as well. Let's take a look. Let's make an offset from this extrude in that direction, that might be 15. Okay, now let's trim or split. I use split. I want to split that surface with that surface, and I want to move this side, and okay. And of course, I need more sketches. I need sketch right there. Change the geometrical set to sketches. Make a positioned one right here. Okay, now I could hide those surfaces, hide those projected elements, and I need a construction rectangle. And of course, don't use those. And need a profile which starts right here, goes up, and then in a tangent arc, and then in another tangent arc here. This should not be parallel. This one and that one should be coincident. This should have a length, maybe 20. This should have a length, 135. And this should be parallel here, not parallel but tangent. So first you have to make this with a distance, and that might be 20. Then this one and that one should be tangent. Okay. Now this one should be 135. Sort of crazy. And add perpendicular, and this line should be coincident to that plane. Let's move this point a little bit if possible, maybe like this. Okay, and that distance might be, for the moment, is at least 100. You could change it afterwards anyway, because that's the first distance here from that plane. Great. Now I think I've got almost all my sketches. Let's go for surfaces, show them. Let's hide this one for the moment and that one for the moment. I want to have a blend. So this should be longer. That was sketch. That sketch. That's more like it. Now let's make a blend. from this edge and that support to this edge and that support. Tangency, tangency, and okay. Nice. I have to split this into four parts. Because I need those segments off. And another consideration, maybe I should first trim it all together with an extrude in that direction. This might be the correct idea. So let's do it. Go for an extrude with this sketch, that direction, and confirm. Now let's trim or split those separate or all together. Or first trim and then split. I could join them, then trim them, and then, but I need those curves.
Yeah.
So just maybe first I will make this extrude, make a pattern, then make another extrude here with a similar curve, and do all the splitting and trimming in the second part of this exercise, because it's already getting very long again. Okay, so let's do an extrude with this sketch, the other way around. Yeah, distance is okay. And confirm. And then make a linear pattern with that face. Make it four instances. Spacing should be 1, 3, 5. And the direction should be, in this case, the y-axis. And okay. Let's hide those surfaces for a moment and go back to our sketches layer. To our sketches geometry set. And those should be, of course, in the surfaces geometry set. So change them to the surfaces set and okay. I need a very similar sketch. So I will copy it, copy, paste, go there, delete this one and move it. Okay, this should be aligned with that axis. Coincident, and that distance is different. So I would have to check over here. That's too much, it's about that length. So maybe I go for, let's say, 100. This might work. If not, I have to change that. Okay. Go back to surfaces and make another extrude. Oh, that's wrong. Because it should be here. Okay. Let's edit that sketch. I made it different, so I'd show that's not coincident here. But coincident to that one. Okay, and now this could be even longer. 135, for example. Show those. Make another extrude with that last sketch. And okay. So I'm done for this part. Hope you enjoyed it up to this point. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page, and please like it over there. It would be very nice of you. So, thanks for watching. See you to the second part. Bye-bye.